Thank you, Natasha. You know what? To give us more insight into this first round of talks with China, we bring in former representative with the USDA, Steve Gill. Thank you so much for joining us, Steve.
Thanks, Scotty.
Okay, Steve, this has just come out. You know, you would think that this was going to be easy. All that we've heard about is how great of a relationship President Biden and his administration has on the international community, especially with China. But last night showed the exact opposite. It was basically a firing squad back and forth at each other of showing that the relationship's not so sweet. Did the British actually think that the Chinese would crack down? Here's my question for you. When it comes to, is this really about Hong Kong or is there more to it?
Well, I think there's a lot more to it. I think what we're seeing, both with the way that President Putin and Biden are going back and forth, with Kim Jong-un refusing to even talk to the U.S., with what you're seeing happen around the rest of the world, and now China's diplomats literally getting right into the face of America's diplomats, there is no respect for the Biden administration in terms of foreign policy, no respect for this president. And I think you're going to see him get tested more and more and more by world leaders. And this is just one of the first salvos.
Well, and then you talk about right now, you look at, you have a tit for tat when it comes from, we're saying that we're going to obviously put sanctions on them. They're saying they're going to possibly limit the visas of Americans that are working in China right now. But what can the administration do specifically that would or could hurt China as it pertains to sanctions? Real hurting that they're not already doing already.
Well, I think, first of all, if you're going to schedule diplomatic meetings, Anchorage in early March is probably not as good a choice as Hawaii in March. So, you know, the choice of that selection also kind of ticked off the Chinese. I think if we want to hurt them, we need to recognize, first of all, that we have a huge economy that they are very dependent upon. China has a massive population. They have huge rural areas that are still dependent upon both food, technology, and American resources that continue to assist them in the world market. So we control a lot of the power of the pocketbook. We need to remember that, and we need to play a little tougher in that if we want to get things back on an even keel with the Chinese. They can play tough. We can play tougher.
Well, and that's my question for you. Who really, though, in today, in the present day, obviously things have shifted over the last decade. Who really do you think has more leverage in the world today, China or the United States?
Well, I think with what you're seeing this administration do again, they're crippling our own ability to compete in world markets. You know, we've got a pandemic. We've had the economic downturn because of that. We are shutting off our energy independence thanks to this administration. We are allowing millions of people to flood into our country and climb onto the back of taxpayers. And now, while we're in a huge recession, huge unemployment, you've got the Biden administration wanting to raise taxes, trillions of dollars that will again stifle regulatory competitiveness for businesses because they can't put the money into development. They're going to have to pay it into taxes. You're going to see a huge impact on the U.S. economy, which only emboldens and encourages our enemies to recognize they can compete better with us.
Well, and that's the thought when you're looking at the conversations that happened last night. I have to tell you, that was pretty tough. That was pretty rude on both parts. But China saying, we can't trust the United States anymore. Those are actually some pretty harsh words against the United States, that they can't trust us to be a part of our bargain, keep up our end. You know, when you're looking at right now what was going on between the two of them, how much do you think this is? You see basically a new old team coming in, working underneath the Biden administration. Do you think the Chinese are going, oh, gosh, it's these guys again? Do you think there's actually some anger to lash out, basically, because they're working with some of the same guys who had failed policies in the past, and they can't trust them because they didn't keep up their word when they worked for the Obama administration?
I think they recognize that the new team is really the old team and that they can push them over. But I think there's something else here that's happening as well. This is theater. This is also show. Not necessarily show for the world stage, although certainly other countries are paying attention. But this is also to play to the Chinese population. They're showing that they're not going to back down to the U.S. They're going to embolden their own folks, their own politicians, to realize that we're playing tough. We're going to be the new player on the world stage. So I think a lot of what's going on here is not necessarily for our consumption or even world consumption, it's for consumption in China.
Well, and that's a big part of it. Obviously, it's a PR campaign on both sides to look who's tough. And I have to tell you, this past week has not looked so good for the United States and how we're handling things. But you also look at, I hate to bring up the past, but, you know, Steve, we first brought you on the show 2 years ago talking about Trump and his negotiations with the Chinese. And we were seemed like we were at a stalemate, but at least they were talking. And I don't think I remember sort of the words crossing each other that are this harsh. They obviously were never contentious. They never really got along, but at least they felt like there was a trade deal that was in the works. Where does this go from now? If it's starting off like this, how do they salvage this? And do you actually have realistic expectations for a good trade deal that will stick, that both sides will be happy with?
Well, the trade deal is in place. The question is, will it be enforceable? I mean, as we've talked before, one of the biggest factors in that trade deal was not just the flow of goods back and forth, the flow of services back and forth, but the protection of American intellectual property. Would we be able to not only win some of the trade concessions, but also ensure that they would protect the intellectual property, the development, the ingenuity that America provides? Or are they going to keep stealing stuff, making it in their factories, and then shipping it right back to us and to the rest of the world? There is no indication that there's going to be anything tough to stop them from doing that. Now, again, the Biden administration is talking tough, but actions are going to speak louder than words. And I think, again, as they figure out that they may see a backlash, they may see things stifle our economy if they play too tough, they may blink, which is what American administrations have done for 20-plus years.
Well, and that blinking actually can cause a lot of damage, especially when you're dealing with contention with China. At least when China was dealing with Trump, there was always that insecurity as we don't know how which way he's going to go. But when he said it, he stuck with it. And I think right now is the confidence that's lacking. And that's the respect that's lacking, I think, between and why we saw such a breakdown in the first round of talks yesterday in Anchorage. Steve, thank you so much for continuing to share your point.
Thanks, Scotty. Thank you.